How we doing out there, guys? This is the Canada Social Sports Podcast, man. This is your host, Carey Barisotti, coming to you live. Let's talk about it. Let's do it. NBA playoffs. What do you guys think? What are your thoughts? I think last night, Kings-Warriors game, Harrison Barnes, I am so sorry to admit it, bro, but there's a reason why they traded you, bro. There was a reason why you got let go after that 2016 finals. There's a reason why the core that the Warriors were building, they said, I'm good with these three, but you're not the fourth piece. There's a reason why Kevin Durant came. There's a reason why Andrew Wiggins' trade came about. The list goes on and on, guys. You never was a good three-point shooter. You are an overpaid Uncle Green, which is Jeff Green. Anybody knows who I'm speaking about and that knows basketball. That is not a shot to Jeff Green and or Harrison Barnes. That is a basketball equivalent of what you add up to. Hard-nosed player. You leave it all out there. That's not your shot. Darion, you are a tremendous point guard. God willing, you stay healthy. What you guys got going on over there in the Kings with Sabonis and the pieces you guys got around you guys, you're going to do something crazy out there. You're going to bring that value back to Sacramento. But to say, hey, you know what? This is the last 10, 15 seconds of the game. I'm the star point guard. This isn't Sabonis' role. You take that shot. But again, what does your coach teach you? That was the right play to make. That was the right pass. Harrison Barnes did shoot 37% from the three-point line this year. So it's not like you're above and beyond, like, no, it's a crazy play. You didn't pass it to your center to shoot. Draymond Green is on you. I get the defensive pressure. I understand the hezo. I understand the ball lost. I understand the 30-foot jumper. I get it. But why weren't you in attack mode? You were the fastest player in the NBA. Like, why didn't you go to the hole? Man, listen. There's a crazy stat that I heard, and shout out to Stan Van Gundy, man. Jeff Van Gundy. He said that Dwayne Wade is the best end game closer that he's ever seen. He didn't say end game shooter. He didn't say end game taker. End game closer means that he gets the ball, you know they're going to win. We looked it up. 75 plus attempts. Dwayne Wade shot the most, highest percentage. You would have asked me, do I want Kobe or Wade to shoot the last shot? I would say Kobe. You would say, would you want LeBron or Wade? I would say LeBron. Like, the list goes on and on. MJ, Wade, you're taking MJ. Like, but stat-wise, the Flash, best endgame shooter of all time. We talk about playoffs. We talk about the NBA. We talk about, you got to mention Greek the Freak. You got to mention Joel Embiid. Like, both these guys are injured. Thank the Jesuses that I want the Sixers to make it this year. I picked the Sixers to come out. If the Lakers don't win it, I want Philly to win it. I need James Harden to get that ring. I need Embiid to get that ring. Out of the West, if the Lakers got to go, I want the Nuggets to take it. I don't want to see the Suns. I'm a huge Suns fan. Been a Suns fan forever. But to see the KD trade come in after the end of the year, it's just going to get KD's head bigger and bigger and bigger. And Chris Paul, one of my favorite point guards of all time, but your longevity of your career is the only thing that helps you like this. Darion Williams is better than point guard you back then, and you're just playing right now. You're too old to carry the show as a number three. Devin Booker, as you can see what Jimmy Butler did with the clamps, like, he's not that guy to create, and you guys are ball dominant. KD, you're stuck just catching and shooting. This isn't Clay and Steph. That's what everybody has to understand. DeAndre Ayton is not even a poor man, Kevon Looney. Not even a poor man, JaVale McGee. DeAndre Ayton disappears when it counts. He's good for the first two halves of basketball. Maybe midway to third. Better than that, he's done. He's not the guy. I've never seen a big guy get paid so much and do so little since Roy Hibbert. And say what you want about Rory, but at one point he was the best. He held down that Indiana Pacers team for those 3-4 years. Who's to know if Danny Granger never got hurt? Who's to know if Paul George never got hurt in the Olympics. I mean, they were gearing up to put the breathing. Not the beating, the breathing. That's like the birth and the ass whooping of first time ever LeBron. Like, I was going to tell you that year the Pacers was going to kill him. The Olympics come out, Paul George is killing, he's doing his thing, he's doing PG-13 type of things, and boom, the incredible leg break. The same summer before it, Danny Granger, bam, ACL gone. Jermaine O'Neal, Roy Hibbert started feeling the MCL pains on his right knee. It just started to crumble from there, guys. Then LeBron took over, beat the Mavs, guys leg back, yada, 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 fairy tale over. I get it. But the playoffs where you see your best basketball. Do you guys see what Jalen Brunson is doing right now with the Knicks? Can we please give a shout out to Jay Barrett? The man I told you 3 years ago coming out of Duke is one of the best two-way players in the NBA. But he can't shoot, Kerry. He just dropped 18-7 this year. 19-7, sorry. He is killing in the playoffs. And guess what? RJ Barrett is the best compliment to little Jalen to little Jalen you can ask for. Brunson's small. It's my height, 6 foot, 6'1". But do you see what he's doing? And do you know what they just did by putting Josh Hart into that team? You just gave 4 years of college experience together into the same backcourt. Great trade. Great trade, New York. You just gave all the confidence to Brunson. Julius Randle, all the confidence. Obi Toppin, what did you come from? You're killing Donovan Mitchell. Bro, where's your threes at? Give you a crazy stat right now. Donovan Mitchell been in the league for 7-8 years now. Curry's first 7-8 years in the league. Guess who's projected to have more three-pointers? You ready? You said it. Nope, not Steph Curry. Donovan Mitchell. At this point in his career right now, Donovan Mitchell has made and taken more three-point attempts than Steph Curry at this point in his career. Where are you at? How are you the face and you disappear? You blamed Rudy Gobert all those times in Utah. Oh, God, did you? He hugs the lane. You sound like Cat and Ant over there in the Timberwolves. He doesn't play offense. He's got a lob. He doesn't roll hard. Blah, 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 blah. What's your excuse now? Big man's rolling to the hole really hard. You got Evan Mobley killing the game. You got Jared Allen and Evan Mobley. Come on, bro. Both all-stars. Darius Garland came out killing yesterday, but you disappeared last game. You got the Celtics that's coming. What are you going to do? Bye-bye, Cavs. I don't know. I don't know what you trade. I don't agree on breaking up the Evan Mobley, Jared Allen. I love what you're doing with Darius Garland, but Donovan Mitchell, this falls on you, bro. You made all that hoopla about it, and this falls on you, man. It is the Canceled Sports Podcast. It's in Season 2. I'm enjoying it. It's the NBA playoffs. Tonight, we got Heat Bucks. Greek the Freak's coming back. I'm picking the Bucks to win this one. He was in the Monday morning shoot-around, so I'm projecting him to play 30-plus minutes, giving you 25-plus. He's going to come kill. Lakers tonight, taking the Lakers in a thrilling game. In a thrilling game, the fact of Marshawn, I should say Marshawn, Mr. Brooks, play ball, son. Go out there, do what you do. You're not the offensive player. You shot 3 for 16 last game. You're not Russell Westbrook. You're not that guy. You're taking shots away from Jared Jackson, defensive player of the year over there. Taking shots away from Desmond Bane, one of the top three-point shooters in the NBA. Be a little smarter, guys. I like to see Big Boy Lofton get a little more burn in there. I like to see the coach use his little sense in there because I know it's not the position to play him, but at least he'll get 80 in the foul trouble. He's a big body. He's going to attack the hole. Play basketball. See a good game out there tonight. It's Canceled Support Podcast, man. Tell a friend to tell a friend.